Good afternoon, everybody. I hope everybody's having a great day. Thank you for joining us today for Noesis's weekly webinar, Web-Based Tools for Selling Efficiency Projects. My name is Taina Palumbo-Price, truncated here because it doesn't fit, and I am a part of product marketing here at Noesis, and I am happy to be joined by my colleague, William Ball, who is a product manager here at Noesis. Hi, William.
Hi, Taina.
I want to just quickly walk us through today's agenda, and then I'll hand it off to William to get through all of his topics. So I'm going to quickly give a Noesis overview, and then William's going to talk about project proposal lifecycle, and then he's going to demo some online tools, and then we're going to leave some time there at the end for Q&A. So for those of you who haven't been on one of our webinars before, I'd like to just take a second to sort of set the stage and give you a little bit of information about what Noesis is and what we do. We're the world's leading platform for energy project financing and savings, and we're used by energy professionals to do more energy projects. On the right-hand side of the screen there, you'll see just a smattering of some of the customers that we are currently working with. We have over 100 customers currently using our products and services today, and that number is growing every single day. In the last quarter, we signed up 28 project developers and efficiency companies that do work like you. You may notice some names that you are familiar with here on the list of customers that we work with, like Enernoc and Trane are pretty well known within the energy efficiency space, and you may see some names of people that you maybe don't know, but all in all, what we do is try to get people tools and services that help them build their businesses and get more energy projects completed. Okay, so thank you for giving me that time to sort of talk to you about what we do. Now I'm going to hand it off to William.
All right, thanks, Taina. So the topic of our webinar today is web-based tools for selling efficiency projects. And we want to set the stage for this conversation by talking about the three phases of a project proposal. So there's a lot of different ways to think about the life cycle of a project, but one of the simpler ways that we're going to concentrate on to make things clear and easy to digest is breaking things up into first project development, which can include everything from engaging your customer, qualifying sales prospects, being able to really originate and identify project opportunities. So it's the very early important steps to get you into a place where you can then move on to the next step, which is project analysis. So this is really consists of the phase in which you are doing audits and you are potentially doing additional analysis, energy engineering calculations once you have already done some of the upfront due diligence to demonstrate what opportunities might be available at the facility. And then that flows nicely into the last step, which is project proposal. And so this is once you have not only identified a sales prospect or someone in your company that is interested in an energy project being done, you've also done the analysis, you understand what is going into the different energy conservation measures and specific savings that you're projecting and expecting from those measures. And then you're packaging them together and presenting them away in a way that whether someone has energy expertise or more than likely they don't have energy expertise, can understand the financial and business viability of the energy savings measures that you're proposing. And so these are the three main categories that we're going to be talking about. And so first, we'll get into project development. Now, there's a lot of great tools out there in project development in this phase. One of the really important aspects, of course, is to do benchmarking, to understand how a facility compares to its peers. And this helps you understand whether opportunities exist. Once you've already connected with a customer, they've enabled you to get their utility data. In this, there's a lot of great tools out here that you might be familiar with. Probably, definitely the most popular and the most widely used is Energy Star Portfolio Manager. We're going to do a very brief demo of Portfolio Manager to get you oriented to some of the things that it enables you to do in a moment, as well as a demo of some other tools. But Energy Star is basically a free program that enables you to do some basic benchmarking, understanding of how a facility is performing. It enables you to compare to peers, particularly through the use of an Energy Star rating, which is a very digestible, easy to understand way of ranking your facility compared to peers. There's also other tools out there that are paid, because Energy Star Portfolio Manager is a free program, but there's also other paid programs that get a little bit more deeply into benchmarking. Energy Scorecards, buildingbenchmarks.com are some examples of those. Noesis also has some benchmarking tools that you can leverage. There's also a very important data set that's one of the most commonly used one in the industry, and there's some others that are like it, and it is called CBEX, which is the Commercial Buildings Energy Consumption Survey. And CBEX serves as a great way to understand how different facilities are performing. It has really deep data. Not only are there thousands of buildings, but it also enables you to understand the different components of energy in use within a facility, lighting, heating, cooling, et cetera, for a given building. And so all of those are great tools and resources that are available that we'll look at a little bit more in a moment. Energy auditing, this process of understanding where the money is actually going, being able to generate, you know, energy recommendations, do that additional or initial, rather, due diligence of understanding what opportunities might exist in the facility, doing equipment inventory, those sorts of things, leading up to when you're going to do your energy modeling, energy engineering calculations. And one of the great examples we'll look at for this is a company called KW Hours, and they have a nice tool that enables you to have some mobile auditing capabilities, and we'll look at that. We'll also look at a tool called the Project Savings Estimator that is something that's offered by Noesis and Noesis Pro, as Taino was talking about a little bit earlier. And what the Project Savings Estimator enables you to do is essentially get over what is commonly known as the data wall. So very commonly, it is difficult in an initial conversation with a financial decision maker to start talking about utility data and audits and all these sorts of intensive things that are very important in developing and analyzing a project. But a customer, especially someone who is financially minded, is going to want to have some sort of general or ballpark understanding of what savings could be expected in their facility before they let you have access to their facility, before you take the time of their staff, before you acquire utility data. And so what Noesis does is actually enable you to leverage a lot of different data sets, including CBEX, to estimate what the spend and different energy end uses are at a given facility, and then estimate what savings might be. And so this is kind of a sales qualification step that enables you to make sure that you're doing audits for the right customers. Because what we found is that in a lot of times, energy efficiency service providers are doing audits for customers that actually aren't qualified. Maybe a facility manager is interested in an audit, but if the financial decision maker hasn't gotten on board with the concept of doing a project, then you can be wasting your time. So we want to make sure that you're efficient in doing audits for the right people. Some other resources that are useful in project development that can often stimulate project ideas and potentials are rebates and incentives. Noesis has some incentives that we pull in from a lot of data sources, including Desire. Both of these are free resources that you can leverage and enable you to identify different incentives as well as policies that are great stimulants for project opportunities that might be available to you and your customers. So let's go ahead and zoom out of the PowerPoint real quickly. And what we're going to do is look at some of the examples that we just talked about. First, we will look at Energy Star Portfolio Manager. So I've logged into my account on Portfolio Manager, which is, again, is a free program that you can leverage to do some basic benchmarking, get Energy Star ratings. And what we can do is we scroll down here in the My Portfolio tab, we can see some overall trends of our source EUI. We can also look into site EUI a little bit later. And source EUI is what is the total energy use intensity that is backing all the way up to you know, the generation components to produce the energy used in the facility. Site is focused on what the building actually uses with regard to energy. So that's what this metric is. You can see that I have a number of properties that are in Portfolio Manager. If I go over into sharing, this is a very useful feature that has recently undergone an overhaul along with the entire Portfolio Manager product. It enables you to share your data with other service providers and applications, including Nuesis. And so Nuesis has a two-way integration with Portfolio Manager. So you, if you use this tool, you can push data into Nuesis. You can pull data from Portfolio Manager as well. And so it goes both directions. And when you share your data, it can enable you to take advantage of other applications without having to duplicate data entry. There's some different planning tools that you can use to understand how your properties might be meeting different energy targets. You can even set baselines for specific facilities. And in the reporting function, we'll be able to see that there's a lot of charts and graphs you can take advantage of. Everything from performance highlights, you can even leverage some data about carbon emissions and footprints of your facilities. There's information about some of the other utility types outside of energy, and then of course your ENERGY STAR certification status if you're applying for a ENERGY STAR certification and designation at your facility. So there's a lot of great tools in here. This is not meant to be a training of all of Portfolio Manager. The US EPA does a great job of putting those trainings on if you want more information. Another tool we want to look at is from another source, from the U.S. Department of Energy in this case, and this is the Energy Information Administration. And this sub-branch of the U.S. Department of Energy is the organization that administers the CBEX survey, and so they have an enormous amount of data on all sorts of utility types, really anything that relates to energy. They have information that not only applies to the U.S. but also globally. There's a lot of different tools that you can see up in here that can relate even to specific generating capacities, things like renewables, if you want to get into that, topics and projections. And then they also have some pretty useful data browsers. And these are the sorts of data sets that are publicly available that are great. Nuesis leverages a lot of these, so you can kind of have one place to digest it. But there's some great browsers here as well. You can look at you know, generation and retail rates, for example, for electricity, for commercial use, for example, over time, so I can see how things trend. I could go down and look at a specific map, sector, or area. Maybe I want to see what an average commercial rate is within a specific area of the country. I could do that for a given time period. So this is a great source that we'd encourage you to look at. And then let's go ahead and show you from Nuesis the project savings estimator. So again, this is meant to be a really sales qualification tool to enable you to do energy analysis and do audits for the right customers and be able to communicate with those financial decision makers, introduce financing into the conversation to make sure that you're getting over those budget objections and you're really being able to move with momentum to the next step in the sales process. So this estimate is going to require just some very basic information about a facility. We'll enter in some data about a facility or client name. We can enter in a location. This is going to be leveraged to pull data from climate zones that map to this facility. So you can see I have some map information here. And I'm going to select a sector because I want to compare to buildings that are similar to mine. In this case, we'll look at office, but there's a lot of other sectors available. I'll estimate my floor area, and I can enter a estimated year built in here as well. I'll go to calculate energy spend, and as you can see, the tool is going to estimate what the spend is for this facility. And this is not meant to say this is the exact spend for the facility by any means. It's meant to say that there are, in this case, 31 facilities with these characteristics that together average at about this annual energy spend. So this is meant to enable you to have a ballpark estimate, but definitely a technically informed estimate of what the energy spend at the facility might be so you don't have to collect utility data to just begin the conversation. When we move on to the next step, we'll see that the Noesis platform utilizing data sets such as CBEX, as I mentioned, is going to break down the different end uses, as you can see here. So you can see lighting, cooling, ventilation, some of the other end uses within the facility that are going to dominate. And also, Noesis is even going to give you some recommendations of measures that are common for facilities like this. We pull data from utility DSM programs that enable us to have a good understanding of what some common measures are. You can see some of the ones here. I can also create my own. Maybe I know that for this facility, they've never had a chiller replacement. And so let's say that I want to estimate what savings might be from doing a retrofit that involved that measure. So I could estimate those savings. And again, you can also use some of the Noesis calculated measures as well. That you can see up here pulling from a number of different public databases. And so we'll see on the right-hand side what our cooling savings are. I'll go over to lighting since this is a big area as well. We'll say, you know, if we specialize in lighting and we want to look at doing a comprehensive LED retrofit, we can enter in some estimated savings and estimated costs. So then we can see what this would be like on the right-hand side of your screen. And as I scroll down, I can look at what the annual savings are compared to the current spend. But let's say that I, for whatever reason, wanted to look at measures that affect the entire facility. So maybe they span, maybe it's something related to controls, or maybe you even have a generation project. So you're going to save energy, but it's not just going to be across one load. You could do that here by adding a measure that's going to change the pie chart and show you just what the savings are from your total energy spend. So that's an option as well you can look at. When we move to the next step, we can add some additional information. It could be expertise of your firm in similar facilities. It could be information about typical projects that you do on this type of facility. You could also add in typical incentives that you might be aware of. So we talked about Desire and some other databases that can enable you to understand what the savings or what incentives or rebates might be available. So if you have that information, you can enter that here. It's certainly optional. And then when we move to the next step, you can see we just provided some pretty basic information. This is something that we can put together very quickly, provide to a sales prospect. And what we're going to be able to see here is not only some context about our facility, our overview, but we're going to be able to compare our costs if we do nothing versus if we implement a project. And so what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to download an example of this. You can see a PDF version. I can put in my contact information as well. And so what we're going to be trying to communicate is what is really the cost of doing nothing if you do not do a retrofit at this facility. We're not trying to say what the exact energy savings for each individual year are going to be, but we want to give a high-level understanding of what those might be. And so as we scroll in here, we can see this chart that we often like to refer to as an IQ test, which is if a financial decision maker is not enticed by doing an energy project when they see that their waste could look something like this, if they don't do measures over a typical project life, and that they could have these savings achieved by financing so they don't even have to come out of pocket, then they're probably not someone you should spend time doing an audit for. And so we want to make sure that you can be really effective and efficient in your sales process, communicating with the right stakeholders who have an understanding of, okay, this isn't just about kilowatt hours, this is about the life cycle savings that I could benefit from if I did a project in my facility. And then when you go into the audit at that point, you have some additional momentum. So this document is also going to have the information we looked at a little bit earlier, just to provide some context about some of the assumptions that went into this. We referenced some of the databases here below, and you, of course, can customize this with your information and your branding as well. So that is what we wanted to show you as far as the project savings estimate. Once you have secured an audit, you're working on behalf of the right prospects who are interested in the potential of doing a project and what you specialize in. There's some other tools out there, such as KW Hours, and what this can enable you to do is they have a mobile app you can leverage on your iPad, for example, and what it's going to enable you to do is collect a lot of the different audit information that typically is just done on paper. And so you can see kind of a online clipboard, so to speak. There's some different capabilities to take in images and other information blueprints that are going to be relevant to understanding kind of the lay of the land within a given facility. And so this is a for-fee solution, but we definitely see some value in tools like this to make your audit process more efficient. So now that we've covered some of the different tools that are available to you in the project development phase, let's go ahead and talk through the next steps of project analysis. So at this point, you've done some benchmarking, you know where a building stacks up compared to its peers, you've made sure that you've communicated effectively with the financial decision maker of your prospect at a facility, and you want to get into the energy modeling, the energy engineering calculations that are going to inform your proposal. So there's obviously a lot of different software packages out there that can help you with this. There's a lot of different modeling software that you can utilize, eQuest, DOE 2. There's a lot of different resources out there that you can leverage. We want to focus on some other ones for you to utilize as well. There's a lot of power in being able to provide input to your new calculations of what savings might be in a given facility by having relevant and verified case studies based on similar projects. So that's not only a powerful marketing tool, but can also inform your analysis, understanding what is truly possible. Because as we know, as great as different energy modeling software tools out there are, those are simulations. And so they always need to be informed by and improved on by actual savings that have been achieved by similar projects. You can see kind of a snapshot of a verified case study on Nuesis. There's a new site that is available called www.energymanagement.org. And this is a really great place where you can view many different types of case studies across technologies, buildings, and industries, because there's a lot of great free resources on the web, but oftentimes there's not a clear and easy to navigate place to find these and stack rank them and compare them side by side. So we're going to look at some examples of energymanagement.org a little bit later. Another set of tools we want to talk about that is pretty new is, as you're probably aware of, the U.S. Department of Energy has a lot of different national laboratories, NREL, the Berkeley Lab, and the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory as well. There's a number out there that are very focused on energy efficiency and energy in buildings, and they have a lot of different resources that can complement your analysis. One of the more recent ones is the NREL Laboratory in Golden, Colorado. They have a new tool called the Building Component Library, and it can be a resource to help you look at common building components and help you make some of those assumptions about what's going on in the building, what savings might be like. It's kind of got an open source approach, so you can submit information to it, and it's meant to be kind of a crowdsourced component library where people can vet different information. So that's a great and growing resource as well. So let's go ahead and look at some examples that we can see from what we just discussed. So first, let's go ahead and look at some of the case studies at energymanagement.org. And so this is a site where you can even add your own case studies. You can request to have your case study verified as well. And there's a lot of case studies that are already populated here. There's a video for further explanation if you want. So we have a simple keyword search. We can also utilize some of these filters here. We can look just by facility type, for example. We could look by technology. So maybe we only want to look at things that relate to chillers, for example. Maybe we want to look just at a specific industry. So let's say, for example, we want to you know, look at a specific area here, let's say education, for example. And here we're going to see specific education-focused case studies. We can filter the results even more if we wanted to. So we can see, for example, there's 8 Boiler case studies just focused on education. You can see what some of the savings are very quickly. So these are broken down for you. You don't just have to dig down into the details of the case study. You can see the source behind them. And you can download this information for free. And so you can see there's a lot of really great industry-leading organizations, everything from training organizations like South Face out in Georgia to different energy service providers such as Siemens. You can see some other great programs from utilities such as PG&E and Con Edison. So there's a lot of great resources here that are available for you. And so let's kind of drill down a little bit further. Let's say we just wanted to focus on boilers. We could do that here. So it's very easy to navigate and very easy to understand what are the different case studies that are most relevant for you to look at. And in addition to the overall savings, it's really great to dig down into some of the details of these case studies that provide a lot of valuable context for you to utilize when you're supplementing your project analysis. So now let's go ahead and go to the NREL site that we were talking about, the Building Component Library. So you can create a free account here. But let's go ahead and look at some of the different components and measures. So components are specific building components or building blocks, so to speak, that can enable you in the energy modeling process to efficiently gather different assumptions that are going to be relevant. So let's dig down and see what some of these examples are. So we can see it's broken down by type. We have a lot of location-dependent components. You can see about 28,000. That's a pretty large number. This data set is growing very fast. You can see that in HVAC, you have a breakdown between things from boilers and fans, for example. You can see we have a lot of examples in lighting. And a very large amount in construction assembly as well. So if we go into fenestration, for example, when we're talking about glazing or windows, you can see that I can download specific components here. And if we dig down into a specific example, we'll be able to see some information that's taken, in many cases, from different industry standards. So this is going to be really important if you're talking about energy modeling, to have components that align with those standards that are used to design buildings. We can see ASHRAE standard 189 and some of the other inputs that are going into this that are informing these building components. And if we go back to the home page, we can look at some of the measures that can then be applied. So once you have essentially modeled and built out what the facility basically looks like and how it behaves, you can go into specifics behind different types of measures that are going to oftentimes be applicable here. And so we can see a number of the different types of measures. So let's say we're looking at this ERB here. So this is a model measure. We can see a description, some useful context. There's even a rating system as well, so you can vote for how well a given ECM is. And you can download it directly in different file types, such as OpenStudio. So hopefully you have a little bit of an understanding now about some of these different tools. Some of them are new, some of them are old, but the landscape is definitely evolving. There's a lot of great information out there from a lot of different industry stakeholders. Now let's go ahead and look at project proposal. So this next step, some tools that can enable us to be really effective in communicating a formal presentation of energy saving measures that can be applied to one or more facilities. So we want to kind of break this conversation up into two. So on one hand, there's the whole concept of proposal collaboration, being able to share charts and graphs and a web portal, being able to communicate on all the different analysis that goes on. One of the things that we found, and I think a lot of us know from past experience as well, is that you often get into a version control nightmare when you're working on a proposal, especially if you have a number of stakeholders who are involved, because one person's doing calculations, another person is working with the customer, another person might be working on data entry, and then you have all those things kind of overlapping. And it's really important to be efficient and have all of that information in one place so that everyone can be informed of the different iterations. Maybe the calculations have been adjusted because some of the assumptions changed by someone who's doing the calculations. That's going to need to be communicated clearly to, you know, your team members you're working with, as well as your end customers. So that's a really important component. Additionally, there's other tools out there that can enable you to supplement your proposal process, to be able to communicate in very specific language cash flows and financing where it's proposed. And so Nuisys has a finance estimator that can enable you to do this. It's similarly very simple, similar to the savings estimator that we were looking at a little bit earlier. What it can enable you to produce is a quick document that's one page, as you can see here on the screen, to help communicate what the savings are going to be if you introduce financing into the conversation. And in this case, you can see that we're actually cash flow positive at the beginning of the project. So that's the tool we're going to look at. We're also going to look at a very new tool that has just been released in Nuisys Pro that is called the Efficiency Business Proposal. And these combination of tools really enable you to be very effective in communicating the impact of a proposal that you're doing. So let me go ahead and go over to a finance estimate real quickly here and just show you an example of what one of these looks like that I've already created. So in this example, you can see we have some information about the facility, and we're going to be able to communicate very clearly in the language of the CFO. So we want to make sure that once you've actually done an audit, once you have put together your calculations and you have a very specific idea of what savings might be for a facility, we can input that information, produce a finance estimate. This could be attached to your proposal, or you can wrap it into a business proposal we'll look at in a moment. And it's going to break down things like the investment, the lifecycle savings. We'll be able to see the different term of the financing arrangement. You can see cash flow very critically. As we scroll down, you'll be able to see that our savings are actually increasing over time. So you can have utility rate escalation assumptions in there, which are certainly going to be impactful in the areas in which you've seen historical rises in utility prices. That's an option you can leverage. You can include incentives as well baked into this. And so this is a very easy document that you can produce in complement to your proposal. And then we also have other tools to enable you to communicate with your other stakeholders about the project, not only your customers, but also your internal team members. On the right-hand side, you can see that we have different stakeholders that we've included in this project. You can invite them to it utilizing Nuisys Pro. So this could be your customers, again, or it could be your different team members. As we scroll down, you're going to be able to see the investment breakdown of we've broken down in a lot of detail here the specific energy conservation measures that we're looking at. You can see these economic summary that's very focused on the financial perspective, because again, we want to assume that the CFO or the financial decision maker that we're proposing this to doesn't have a whole lot of knowledge about energy, which is generally going to be the case. We also have some great ways for you to be able to add and subtract different ECMs. You're going to see these calculations refresh instantly to enable you to do some scenario analysis, understand what combination of ECMs is going to produce the most favorable financial returns that meet the hurdle rates of your end customers. We'll also be able to see a breakdown of annual savings, lifecycle costs. So this is a great way to really bring together all of the key investment aspects of your proposal in one location. And you can even include financing into this package as well. And so if we go up to download proposal, we'll be able to have an output like we're looking at here. It's going to have your brand. It's going to really, again, focus on the investment perspective on this energy savings measure. So we're going to be able to see the different economics, everything from simple payback, but certainly moving on to more robust financial metrics, internal rate of return, net present value, on savings investment ratio. All of these things are really critical in communicating the value of an energy efficiency project. One of the things that's unfortunate is oftentimes people only talk in terms of simple payback or ROI, which really undersells the long-term cash flows that can be realized from a energy efficiency project. And so we want to make sure that we don't undersell the value of these energy projects. And so we're going to be including that information up there in the first page. We'll have some breakdown of the annual savings and the different ECMs that are included. Here we can look at more details of financing, similar to what we were discussing earlier, breakdown of the project economics, some of the different assumptions of equipment life and cost of capital. We can see a breakdown of the life cycle savings, so cash flows in different years on an ongoing basis. We can look at different scenarios side by side if it's self-funded or if it's financed, as well as different assumptions and information about the project team. So all in all, what we're looking at here is a lot of different tools that can enable you to effectively not only build out a proposal, but also be able to communicate to your end customers the value of the energy efficiency projects that you're looking at. So hopefully you've gotten a good idea from all of the different phases of the project, from project development, analysis, to proposal, that there's a lot of great tools and resources out there that you can leverage to be more efficient and more effective when you're proposing and selling energy efficiency projects. So with that, we'll turn back over to Taina.
Thank you, William. That was really helpful. If you guys were a little bit late in joining us, I just quickly wanted to remind folks that we discussed all of the different offerings that Noesis has. And before we jump into the Q&A, which I hope people are filling out, I'd like to just quickly remind folks of the things that we offer. And I'm going to relaunch that poll just in case anybody was interested in talking to somebody more about what we discussed at the beginning of the hour. And just as a reminder, we have Noesis Financing Services, which are expert efficiency finance services and support for all of your project proposals, and Noesis Pro, which are our state-of-the-art web-based tools for selling energy efficiency. And Noesis Pro includes some of the things that William was talking about today, including the efficiency business proposal, which you talked about and demoed a little bit at the end there, and also the savings estimates. So why don't you guys take a second now to answer the poll and also submit your last questions. And while you do that, I just wanted to scan through this last slide, which is a sort of a representation of some of the projects that we have going on in our current pipeline. And what I mean by that is these are the projects that we are working with our customers to get pushed through through financing and to get approved through their customers and their customer CFOs. So you see we sort of run the gamut of sizes and types of efficiency products. And then also you'll see here that we have a wide variety of financing vehicles that we offer, from capital leases to this PPA for solar. And then we've also got a couple of PACE and ESA deals going on. So we really do have a comprehensive grasp on the different types of energy efficiency projects and vehicles, and our customers are working on all kinds of things with us right now. So hopefully you've all got your questions in. Let's just dive right into that. Sorry, I skipped too far. William, do you have any questions there you think you want to answer?
Yeah, we got a number coming across. We'll try to get to all of them. If not, we'll be sure to follow up with answers to some of these. So one of the questions that came across, I think probably in reference to the savings estimator and maybe the finance estimator as well, is do you include consulting costs in total project costs? And so that's a good question. When we talk about project costs, typically we're talking about gross project costs that can include soft costs, such as even maintenance or other services that are baked into there. Those are costs that typically can be included in different financing vehicles as well. And then what we'll do is enable you to apply things like incentives or other different adjustments. Maybe there's maintenance savings or things like that you want to include. Those can be broken down as well. So yes, you can include soft costs, both in financing typically and also in the tools. It looks like we have a question that is definitely relevant to the overall topic we're discussing of how do you help CFOs or your customers understand ROI? And so that's a really great question. What we want to do at Noesis and certainly any tools that you're leveraging or services to help you sell efficiency projects need to be able to communicate not only the return on investment from an energy efficiency project, which you can build trust in by having a lot of different data that's informing your estimates and the calculations you're doing. So that's why we like to go over a lot of these tools that we discuss. But you also need to be able to talk in language that is, you know, goes beyond just ROI, even though that's a starting point. So internal rate of return, net present value, metrics such as that are going to be really critical in helping a CFO understand that you understand not just energy, so not just kilowatt hours, but also cash flows and what this is going to do not only for an annual budget, but for the long term in terms of the savings from a given energy efficiency retrofit. And so those are going to be really important for you to communicate as well. It looks like we have some other questions here about what percentage of energy efficiency projects do you see related to Windows? That's a great question. So within Windows or fenestration, you know, of course, there's the actual glazing themselves, and then there's also things like window film or coatings that are going to go on top of it. And so we definitely see some of those projects. Typically for retrofits, which is what Noesis is focused on, there's a little bit less, you know, definitely less window installations that are being proposed in existing buildings than there are in new buildings, of course. But we definitely see some both on the side of, you know, full-blown window installations, replacements, as well as window film. And so some of the ones that we found have been most effective are those that have, you know, not, of course, not only aesthetic value, but really strong paybacks. Maybe there's some tinting involved, maybe there's some sort of shading controls, things like that, or maybe it's a coating solution. Let's see. It's one question is, are you financing small hydropower projects? Good question. That is certainly something we could discuss with you. I don't believe that's something we have done thus far, but we do have a very large and flexible financing syndicate that looks at a lot of different types of projects, whether they be energy retrofits or whether they be generation-focused projects. It looks like we have another question that says, do the analysis tools can show window insulation and envelope ceiling increase energy efficiency projects and enhance energy generation projects? So similar to what I mentioned before, the tools definitely enable you to add, you know, projects related to building envelope or windows. You can certainly include those within the Noesis platform. And there's also, you know, people that are using the platform for things like cogeneration as well. So I think the answer to that question is yes. It looks like we have a question of can you do best and worst case scenarios for pro analysis? Yes, you certainly can utilize the tool to kind of show a range of scenarios. You can do that in different parts of the tool. So you can make different assumptions about what the spend is within the facility. Additionally, you can go into, you know, the projects and have various assumptions of if you do this ECM and it were to perform really well or combine with this other one, what the total outcome would be. So you certainly can build together different scenarios that are contemplated. It looks like we have another question that says, is it presumed that any proposals that your customer creates using your service or tools remains proprietary, or does it go into some sort of library? And then is the answer dependent on whether or not the project is awarded and subsequently verified? So great question. So in OESIS, we very much believe that it's important for you to have control over your data. And so you have access and control your data. We're not sharing it with other people. We're not selling it to anyone else. There's certainly capabilities that over time could allow us to anonymize and aggregate information that could be leveraged and utilized, like you see with other tools, to make people, yourself and others, more accurate in their project development process. But certainly, there's never going to be any identifiable information or secret sauce, so to speak, or your data ever being shared with someone else or being taken out and given away or exposed in any sort of manner. So you definitely maintain control of your ultimate data. Let's see. It says, is the development tool that shows the building's energy profile and consumption breakdown is comprehensive for buildings in Canada? Great question. So there's less facilities that are going to be represented in Canada, although a lot of the northern climate zones are going to have really strong similarities. You can certainly use the tools for not only the U.S., but Canada and other parts. We can pull in, not only map data, but also do estimations of that. Another great thing is that one of the big themes of what we looked at in over the course of the webinar is there's a lot of different industry data sets that are out there. There's so many public data sets that are very useful. And what we want to do at OESIS is continue to vet new data sets and bring the ones that add a lot of value into the tools so you don't have to, do some of that analysis on your own or in spreadsheets and things like that. And so our data sets and the ability to leverage the tools in other countries and other places is certainly something that will continue to grow and improve. We also certainly can pull in weather data and enable you to do all sorts of energy analysis regardless of where you're located, what country that might be in. So there's a lot of flexibility there.
Awesome. Are there any more? Looks like no. Thanks, everybody, for submitting your questions. Like I mentioned at the top of the webinar, we're going to be compiling all these questions and having William help us answer all of the ones that came in today and any that come in over the next few minutes. Really quickly, if by chance you were not able to fill out the survey that we sent out, or I'm sorry, the survey that we posted, and you'd still like to talk to somebody, I just wanted to give you an opportunity to write down this email quickly, prosales@noesis.com. If you have any questions that you weren't able to get in, or if you just want to talk to somebody, go ahead and send us an email at that address, and we will get back to you. I'd like to thank everybody for your time. Looks like we're just a few minutes early, but I will let you get back to the rest of your day, and hopefully we'll see you on a future OESIS webinar. Thanks again.